What's up, family? It's your boy Pico. Welcome to the channel. If you're new to the channel, then go ahead, press the subscribe button or join part of the family. Press the bell icon if you want to get notified whenever I upload a video. Press the like button if you enjoy this reaction. So I went all the way back to the Grace VanderWaal Darkness Keep Chasing Me video. And at the time, I was told that I should, in a sense, do a more upbeat song, a happier song by Grace. And apparently, the most beautiful song that she has ever wrote to Trip 222's opinion. So let me just add opinion to it. But I feel like making a statement like that, then it would require my own opinion, as well as the opinion of the rest of the family as well, on whether is this indeed her best song. So let's hear it out. But I've heard a couple of great songs so far, so you're making me want to rank them now. But obviously there are some songs that I just cannot rank, as they just make you aware of just problems that people suffer from, such as mental issues as well as depression. But let's just check it out and let's see whether is it indeed the best song that Grace has ever written. But the song is called Florets, and it's performed, I think, at the Brooklyn Art Library. So let's just go ahead and check it out. I managed to bring my headphones here because apparently I needed to be prepared for this. So let's just go ahead and get to it.
Florets actually has a fun story. It was near the end of my writing of the album. So I was like drawing this picture of dandelions with the fluff, and I was like, and I wanted to write blowing dandelion fluff or whatever it's called on the top, and just dandelion fluff just like didn't look good. So I asked my mom, what is that white dandelion fluff? Like, there has to be a name for it. Like, it can't just be dandelion fluff. Like, that's impossible. So she looks it up, and it's called Florets. Florets is actually the tip of broccoli as well.
Wow. Firstly, that is something I never exactly thought of, how the tip, or looking at a tip of dandelion, I just assumed that it would just be dandelion altogether. I never thought of actually researching that part. But yeah, that just her talking about dandelion kind of reminds me of an old R&B track by Tevin Campbell called Dandelions. Just an awesome song. If you haven't checked it out or you haven't heard it before, I suggest you go and listen to it. But that's just a side note. Let's just go ahead and get back to it.
And I just want to stress, I'm not singing about broccoli. I am indeed singing about dandelion fluff.
I want to wake up in a dream. The air is soft to breathe, breathe, breathe. So hold on, don't let go. If we fall down, then you should know.
Anything but you and me.
trees, 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 and let go of all responsibilities, so we could just be flowing, flowing.
Okay, let me stop it. When listening with your headphones, this song is just amazing. I don't know, it makes you feel like you're actually there. You hear the instruments and how they come all together perfectly in here, and it's just the greatest feeling ever. Okay, so just diving into the lyrics, what I'm picking up here is that this is just a carefree song. It's talking about being free-spirited. It talks about letting go of everything, because I would like to think that as well as blowing dandelions or blowing the florets would be, it would symbolize that you just want to live a great life, like a carefree life without worrying about anything. And she kind of touched on that in her lyrics, in which she said that I want to let go of the responsibility. As well as she talked about how she wants to grow similar to trees as well. So it's just being carefree, you know, just enjoying a great life, I guess, with no judgments, just you living your own life. And I feel like everyone wants that. And I think when she started that, she talked about just having this great dream. And that also just confirms that as well. So I like the concept of the song. I like the subject matter, and that's what I like about her songs as well, is that it has this great kind of imagination behind it, in a sense. Like, she just touches up on what everyone, in a sense, has felt or feels in a stage of their lives, whether it has been depression, whether it has been self-esteem issues, or whether it is just wanting to live out your dreams, or just being carefree, or not being unbothered. And in a sense, she touches that, and that's, I think, what people love as well about her, is that they can relate to whatever she's talking about. It's not over dramatized, if that's even a word. It's not just overly exaggerated. It's just, in a sense, what we all have felt at some point in life, or we're still feeling. So that's what I like. But anyways, let's just get back to the video, and let me not get sidetracked. Go with me. Ooh. Okay, so that was the end of the song. My thoughts, this is indeed a beautiful song. Don't know if it's the most beautiful from her catalog, as I haven't necessarily touched all of her catalog, or whether it is the greatest from the songs that I have reacted so far. So anyone can have their opinion in regards to that, but I can agree that this is indeed a beautiful song. It is upbeat, as you said as well. It is happy. Definitely a track that you should play, especially if you're going to the beach or you're going on a trip. Then this is that track. As well as if you just want to feel just carefree, this would also be the track that you would play. So this is great. This. And in some instances, you just want to play a song where everyone in the family can listen to without necessarily worrying about certain words. And this would be that song as well. And I've also, what I also like is I like the raspberry, or the rasp in her voice. I like that as well. And I've also noticed that she can as well manipulate her voice, which is a great thing as well. As noted on the Waste My Time, song, where her voice sounded different, in a sense, and this it just shows the kind of artist she is, or how flexible she is, and how she can accommodate any song or the style or the beat of the song as well. But that's my thoughts. If you have anything that you would like to add to for me to react to, just let me know in the comment section down below. Let me know your thoughts in regards to my reaction, perhaps, or this song. Leave a like if you enjoy this reaction. And anyways, if it's night where you are, then good night. If it is day, then may you have a great day while I'm out.